A big thanks to Napoleon Grills for sponsoring this episode.
Hey, I'm Pitmaster X. Welcome to a new episode where we're gonna turn this into something beautiful. Before we get started, I want to tell you guys about our vlog. It's all about behind the scenes barbecuing and all of the details that you don't see in this video. So if you're wondering like, hey Pitmaster X, how did you do this or how did you do that? All of the questions you get, go to the vlog. The link is down below. And just make sure you subscribe. It's going to be awesome. And while you're at it, I want to tell you about our website, pitmasterx.com. We got all the recipes and this one especially written down for you right there. So after you're done watching the video, make sure you like bookmark that website because it's amazing. Free recipes, so many. You're going to get lost forever. And ever. And this is the star of the show for today. Yes, a beautiful flank steak. And this thing is huge, absolutely insane. And we're gonna do something about it because for what I'm gonna do with it, it's way too thick. But let me tell you what this recipe involves. It involves smoked garlic and 2 years aged cheese. Now, the company that this cheese comes from, of course, is from the Netherlands, is one of the best cheese aging companies in the world. They keep, and I actually have a picture of it, like one of these ancient Dutch houses, warehouses, and they stack it up like that on wooden planks. And then a guy comes along and he checks them every now and then and flips them around and they're aging over there. And then when the summer comes and the temperature in the warehouse rises, the sugar caramelizes, the salt crystallizes. So if you had an old cheese before and you get like, you chew on it and all of a sudden it feels like you're biting on something like a little bit of sand, but then it pops open and it's salt. Oh, that's so amazing. That's what this cheese has. And we're gonna use this cheese for the recipe. So then you know it's gonna be good. The first thing to do is to start trimming our meat. I want to get rid of all that silver skin that's on this meat, but I'm leaving on the fat pieces because that fat is so good. Don't get rid of that. We don't want to clean this totally up. We want all of the goodness to still be there while we make the best out of this cut. Then once we got rid of that silver skin, we're going to slice this thing in half. And I don't mean just cut it across. No, we're going to lay it flat and then slice it and make it half as thin as it already is. We're creating the maximum amount of surface. Now, if this scares you a bit, ask your butcher to do it for you. And look at that, we just created the bald eagle steak. Now, you might think, I never heard of a bald eagle steak, Pitmaster X. I don't know. That's right, you don't know because it just has been created. It just happened. I sliced the flank steak in half and I basically butterflied it. And now I have the bald eagle steak. Look, it looks like a bald eagle. Dude, seriously, if we would fillet a bald eagle, it would look like this.
I'm not sure if there's meat in the wings.
Okay. But like the idea of that. You saw it here first, it's happening here, and now I'm gonna fire up my Napoleon barbecue so we can actually get this thing on the fire. While the barbecue is starting up, we're gonna work on our marinade. And it all starts with this beautiful aged cheese. We're gonna grind it down. Yes, I know you're crying. Don't worry about it. I ate a lot of it too. Now it's time for our smoked garlic. I got a whole bulb of garlic that's going in, spring onion, a bunch of celery, a bunch of oregano, a bunch of parsley, 2 handfuls of sage leaves, and a handful of lemon thyme leaves, a few stalks of basil, 200 milliliters of olive oil, and now grind it up. Add a tablespoon of salt. Of course, I'm using fleur de sel, which is a light sea salt. Then add some ground black pepper and some of that beautiful cheese. I like to use a handful, but you can use more if you want to. Wow. Ooh. It just keeps kicking you in the head. That's exactly what I'm looking for, but I gotta process all of this. I need a little bit more salt because we're using it as a marinade. So I'm gonna add another tablespoon of salt. I'm gonna mix this again with the extra salt and then I'm gonna check back. Spot on. Now that our marinade is done, it's time to get it onto our bald eagle steak. Of course, you really want to work it in with your hands. Make sure that you get it everywhere. And you're only going to need a small film of marinade on that steak and it's going to penetrate into it. Once you got the whole steak covered, you're going to set it into your fridge and going to leave it there for at least an hour. I just put the grill grate in. We got the grill super hot. Let's just check out that charcoal. Check it out. I got a bed of coals spread evenly, not too much coals, just a little bit. And this is gonna give us so much heat already. So I'm gonna set my grill grate to the highest position because we got all these herbs on this steak and I don't wanna burn them. So basically I'm looking to cook the herbs, maybe get a little bit of crust on that steak and at the same time cook everything and give like a happy party on that steak. Let our bald eagle become the tastiest thing you ever had. As you can see, there's no fire, there's no flames. We're searing this off nice and easy. And remember, we left the fat on. So this fat is about to melt on from our steak and drip into the fire. So I'm closing the lid. I don't want these huge bursting flames. I want it to cook slowly. And even though I'm going slowly, look at that needle from the grill moving up like it's a race car. This Napoleon kettle grill can get so insane hot. You always have to keep your eye on it. And there's, of course, the best way to control it is just close that bottom vent a little bit. Give yourself some time to grill your steak. Don't worry about going fast, going crazy. Take your time, do it right. I just lowered the grill grate because we're getting close to have this steak finished. What I want is just a little bit more heat to make sure that I got all the outside properly cooked, the fat rendered down. And as you can see, there's a lot of moisture that comes out of this herb mixture. You can see that from the steam coming up from above the grill. Look at my hand, it's just totally covered in steam and a little bit of smoke. So we need that heat to expel that moisture from the outside and just properly cook that steak. Now it's time to let it rest. Bald eagle steak, this is where I get excited. Juicy, tender, look at it, just falls apart. Mm. Oh my God, that's juicy.
A lot of steak, I love it. A lot of really tender looking steak. I'm gonna dig right into it. This looks beautiful.
That's my slice.
No, no, here we go.
Mm. That marinade worked out really well, but the steak is the real star. Like a fresh herb marinade really works well with a steak, but it works well with pork and chicken and basically anything. But together with this steak, it's so tender. It makes it like, it's an elevated dish. It makes it like really, really special.
In my latest video, I've been telling you that inside skirt is my favorite steak. I'm thinking about this steak right now because this might be, it's like, it is like a skirt steak, but it's less chewy.
The only problem with a big amount of marinade like this is you can't have like the insane crust on your steak. So that's like a trade-off that you're going to have when you marinate like this. But on the other hand, who cares? It tastes fantastic.
It's just delicious. It's just really good barbecue delicious. Doesn't matter where it comes from.
You might already seen this plate laying here, but I created this beautiful plate just to make things like restaurant style.
Restaurant style, yeah.
I took some mushrooms, I stuffed them with our marinade, put some cheese on, and then cooked them in the barbecue until they were completely soft. A little bit of greens, some truffle, a good barbecue sauce, and that's it. That's all you need, and just make it look good. Put some effort into it. And of course, if you want to find more about this recipe or you want to have some details about the mushrooms, where did they go?
Of course, you go to the website, man. www.pitmaster.com.
Link is down below.
Link is down below.
So check that out now.
Straight to the recipe. I want to taste this now.
I want to taste it too. One is looking at me.
This one?
No.
This one.
This one, because it's kind of like the cheese is oozing towards me.
I want this one.
It's kind of like...
Can we go?
Like, yeah.
Oh, can we go?
No. I was talking so. All right, there we go. Ready?
Okay. Yeah.
3, 2, 1, go. Oh my God.
Oh.
Now I feel like vegan.
It's amazing.
This is good. The cheese.
Yeah, the cheese, man.
The cheese. Parmesan, move over. Here come the Dutch.
I'm gonna eat another one.
You wanna eat another one?
I'm gonna eat, what, why? Are they reserved?
I wanna just make sure you are sure you wanna eat another one.
Oh, I'm sure.
Otherwise, I would like happily sacrifice myself.
Eat another one. Close off the video, eat another one.
Look at the juices.
Yeah, it's dripping. Mine is not dripping, mine already dropped.
Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, then leave us a big thumbs up in the comment down below. Don't forget to check out our vlog and our website, links down below. Thank you very much. Thank you, patrons. Thank you, YouTube members. See you guys next time. Until then, eat smakelijk.
And keep on grinning.
That's right. You think the dog would eat like a mushroom?
No, it's green. There's green in it.